Today we're discussing whether or not you should do a sleep medicine fellowship and if you really need to do a sleep fellowship in order to help patients with sleep. I'm Dr. Nishi Bhopal. I'm a board-certified sleep medicine physician and integrative psychiatrist, and this channel is for you, the physician who wants to learn more about clinical sleep medicine. If that sounds like you, then go ahead and subscribe to this channel. And before we jump into the video, I'd like to invite you to get my free melatonin brand guide. This will provide you with guidance on third-party tested melatonin brands to consider using in your practice with your patients, because over-the-counter melatonin quality is really a significant concern. You can get that brand guide at intrabalance.com/melatonin. I'll put the link in the video description underneath as well. From time to time in physician Facebook groups, I see this question come up of, should I do a sleep medicine fellowship? Is it even worth doing a fellowship? So we're going to look at that a little bit today and look at some avenues to get sleep education without having to do a fellowship. As always, with any kind of clinical training program, there's going to be pros and cons. Some of the pros I think with regard to doing a sleep medicine fellowship are you can work in different kinds of practice settings. You can work in a sleep clinic, in a hospital-based center. You can work in a private practice. You can do telehealth. There's so many different ways you can practice. What I do is I have my private practice, which is actually a psychiatry practice, but we've got some sleep services carved out. And then I also contract with sleep clinics and I interpret sleep studies. So that's also a nice side gig that doesn't require face-to-face patient care. Some other pros of doing a sleep medicine fellowship are earning potential. Especially if you're in primary care or psychiatry, it's a nice way to supplement your income or increase your earning potential. And of course, you want to consider career satisfaction as well. And if you really enjoy it, then I think it is worth it. Some of the downsides, though, of doing a sleep medicine fellowship are, of course, you take a year off to do it. So then there's that lost earning potential for that year. And if it's not something that you really love, then it might not be worth pursuing. Also, as far as insurance reimbursements, across the board, we're seeing these go down. And this is particularly true for sleep clinics. And the overhead just continues to increase. So there are some of those business considerations as well. But here's my take overall. If you love sleep medicine, if you want to learn more about managing sleep-disordered breathing, in addition to other sleep disorders like narcolepsy, parasomnia, sleep-related movement disorders, insomnia, then go ahead and do it. Sleep medicine is really rewarding. I loved my sleep rotations when I was a psych resident, and I really enjoyed my fellowship. I love learning all about sleep, and so I'm really glad that I did it. And like I was saying before, there's lots of practice opportunities for you to explore. However, if you don't have that passion for really pursuing sleep in that deep kind of way where you're going deep into all of these different sleep disorders, but you really enjoy supporting patients with sleep, or you feel like you need a better grasp on helping your patients with sleep because all of our patients have to sleep, and as physicians, we really don't get much training in it. So if you're a PCP or a psychiatrist or pediatrician or physician of another specialty, you are definitely seeing patients who are struggling with sleep, and you also need to know about sleep as a pillar of health for all of your patients. And you don't really need to take the time out to go and do a full year of sleep fellowship to learn the basics. However, as a non-sleep physician, you do have to know the basics of clinical sleep medicine for a few reasons. One, patients are coming to you first, right? So they're not necessarily going to a sleep clinic first. They're coming to you, and sleep is a pillar of health. And so it's really important that you as the physician understand how to support your patients with sleep effectively, to recognize common sleep disorders, to be able to implement some of those foundational treatments, and to know when to refer out. And as a physician, you have the skill set to help patients get started, to point them in the right direction. And I really want to emphasize that foundational knowledge in sleep medicine is accessible without doing a full year of sleep fellowship. So here are some of the practical things that I recommend that all physicians should know when it comes to sleep. One is recognizing symptoms of common sleep disorders. For example, recognizing atypical presentations of obstructive sleep apnea. You can see last week's video that I did for more information on that. It's also important that you as a physician know what basic diagnostic tools are available, to know what techniques are available, to understand screening tools and their limitations, like the stop-bang questionnaire or the Epworth sleepiness scale. I go into more detail in that in my free sleep mini course. I'll put the link to that underneath if you want to check that out as well. And as a physician, you need to understand initial management of sleep issues and referral protocols as well. So some of these management aspects include basic CBTI technique, beyond the usual sleep hygiene that everyone already knows, doing basic lab workup, which is something that we go into detail inside of my clinical sleep kit program for clinicians, understanding how to use light therapy and melatonin strategically, understanding circadian regulation, knowing what non-pharmacological options are available for insomnia and hypersomnias, and so on. And again, these are all things that we go into detail in inside my clinical sleep kit program. So as you can see, there's lots of benefits to learning clinical sleep medicine without having to go and do a sleep medicine fellowship. Integrating these basic sleep medicine principles into your everyday practice can be incredibly beneficial for your patients, because helping your patients with sleep is going to help improve their metabolic health, their cardiovascular health, their mental health. For example, when it comes to depression and OSA, some clinical studies suggest that the prevalence of sleep apnea among patients with depression is anywhere from 20 to 40%. That's a huge chunk of patients. And so for you as the psychiatrist or the primary care physician, you are seeing those patients. Having sleep on your radar and knowing some basic management techniques is so crucial. And having this knowledge of basic sleep medicine also can help improve patient care and patient outcomes. For example, you can help patients taper off hypnotics or sleep aids that might be detrimental long-term. Supporting patients with sleep is going to help their overall health, like we were just discussing, and also their quality of life, their day-to-day functioning, their memory, communication, and their relationships. And I see my role as a psychiatrist, as a sleep doctor, or as a physician in general, is really to give patients a strong foundation of physical and mental health so that then they can go and explore their full potential of life. It's not just about symptom remission, but really helping patients get to that point where they can live their lives to the fullest. Gaining skills in sleep medicine also enhances your clinical practice. It enhances your professional development, of course. It also can help you have a greater sense of satisfaction, knowing that you're not just prescribing sleep aids and getting into that cycle, which we talked about in a previous video about the difficult and draining clinical encounters. And it's also an opportunity to grow your practice and become known in your community as someone who can really support patients with sleep in a more fundamental and holistic way. If you want to learn more about sleep medicine without having to do a sleep fellowship, there's different educational resources out there. Some of the major universities like Harvard and Penn have online courses that you can take as a clinician. These are CME courses, and they have them on CBTI or cognitive behavioral therapy for insomnia. And they have other focused courses on sleep medicine as well, including sleep disordered breathing and some of the other sleep disorders I mentioned earlier. However, because there's actually not a lot available when it comes to clinical sleep education for physicians, and most of us as doctors only get about 2 hours of sleep education in med school, I've started creating my own courses. That's actually one of the reasons I created this platform, is because I was seeing the gap in the education that is available to us as physicians. So there's this YouTube channel that's available. I also have some free courses. You can get that at intrabalance.com/doctors. I'll put that in the video description. And then I also have my clinical sleep kit online community, which is so much fun. We go into all the fundamentals of sleep medicine. But what's really unique about this program is that you get mentorship, you get community and support. We have live calls, and it's a really great way to enhance your sleep medicine knowledge while also connecting with a network of your peers, in addition to connecting with sleep experts from around the globe. If you love sleep medicine and you've been considering doing a sleep medicine fellowship and you have the opportunity to go ahead and do it, but there's also all these other avenues to explore, to learn more about sleep and to go deeper into the different aspects of it. Whatever you decide to do, you as a physician, you need to know the fundamentals of clinical sleep medicine, because you are seeing patients in your practice who need more support with sleep beyond the basic sleep hygiene recommendations. All of that education is within reach. Let me know in the comments below, are you interested in learning more about sleep medicine without having to do a sleep medicine fellowship? Type yes in the comments if that sounds like you.